Operational report. Submarines detected. Uh-oh, another 17 Echo written off. Crap, they don't make them anymore. Submarine repairs complete. Contact report. Contact report. Am I crazy? Is the E-boat E-escort Suzuki being hit every single turn almost? Is it just my imagination? But we don't sink it. Lots of kills. Kill credit, recon. Fukuoma, Fukuoka, Tsushima, Iwo Jima, Tanjung Pinang, and Chichijima. Lots of recon out. Gotta keep it up. Contact report, no more bombs. At least my submarines haven't been bombed either. Kill credit, recon, contact report. Langkawi, recon. Tanjung Pinang, recon. Repairs complete. Expansions. Well, enemy expands as well. Thank you. Let him build up the base so that I can capture it. Hopefully. Fushan, transferred planes. Okay, promotions. Refit begins. Upgrade. Uh-oh, this is a mistake on my part. Landakotai. Upgrade at Rawalpindi. This is one of those landlocked restricted units. Why upgrade something that's going nowhere? Just a waste of devices, of good men. Repairs complete. Replacements taken. Replacements taken. Okay, upgrade at Kamran. Well, first order of business, going up here to Rawalpindi. Make sure we turn off the darn reef. Why? Oh yes, I had turned these on because I wanted to see if these could we could get them mobile, and now that they are no longer static, I should have turned them off. But now I've upgraded a whole bunch of wasted a lot of good men for a unit that will never leave the continent. Bad idea. Okay, we'll find this one at Rawalpindi. Let's make sure that all the other ones get turned off as well. Let's not waste any more upgrades on these guys. Same with the unit over at Lahore. There's a couple, the Korhat Brigade. Let's make sure that they're upgrade. They do not upgrade anymore. They've already upgraded. Waste. Okay, and the last piece of this is in Saigon. No, this guy's already turned off the upgrade. We're taking replacements simply because they're in combat, but I should turn them off as well. We don't need them. This guy's locked in to the base, locked in, and we can't get him out. I will try to recombine them. Maybe if they recombine, they will be something magical will happen. I don't think so. I don't think so. I believe the Punjab Division will be locked with Northern Command and unable to escape. But I can't be certain of that. Before we investigate China, I wanted to show the losses for this turn. We have shot down or destroyed 39 enemy aircraft, 39, actually 48 for 9 in return. So, what, that's 5 to 1, not great, not too bad. But the aircraft losses, let's take a look at today's losses. For us, we lost 2 Echoes, 17 Echoes, and we don't make any more of those, which is a real shame. That's the problem. But I also lost 2 P-38, one to air-to-air, and one to ops. I can understand the ops, well, you never know where it happens, but I didn't see any combat that shot down. None of my fighter sweeps registered a loss, which makes it really annoying. How do you find out where you change things or fix things if you don't even know where they are shot down? Fusan, we'll take a look at the aircraft here. Only the fighters. We can see there are P-38 Gulf. We have a full squadron here. Well, I don't know. Maybe we lost one of these or even one of these. Just can't tell. The sweepers. I can't tell. Yeah, this one got transferred. We had, I think, 8 reserve, but now there's only 5. So either we lost them or they got taken back by the AI. nothing happening on Hong Kong. Submarines are still in refit. Shanghai, we have submarines. The Sea Raven's back in. We will order her to Pierside since she will upgrade at the same time. And the other three, they're finished their refit. Great stuff. So we'll send them back out, one for each of the patrol stations. Nagasaki, Shikoku, and Chiba. Fusan, we are taking these are the sweepers. Okay, they were... the fatigue is 8 and 6. That's not bad. That's not bad. Well, first we'll rest them all. We'll put it all P-38 Gulf. I'm going to break them up so that we don't transfer out too many of these aircraft. They're all resting. We'll take the other... Where's the other group? Here's the other group. Here's where I lost the damn pilot. Crud. Now, what do I want? What kind of veterans do I want in this squadron? I'm thinking we've got 3,700 squadron. I don't know if I want to use up all the top pilots in these. Well, I probably should, hey? You know. Well, we've got lots of other squadrons training up pilots. The sweepers are probably the most dangerous duty we have. So I'm gonna grab the top pilots. If we use up all the 80s, that's fine. That's fine. Look at all that training. Look at all that experience on here. Use them all up. Let the other guys with the P-40 kilos, these guys, they're just conducting point defense. They're still training. They're still increasing the skill level and the number of pilots, but let them do the grunt work while the long-range sweepers take the risks. Okay, here's a... Okay, let's grab two and two more. Then we'll rebuild. We're going to sweep at 25,000, hopefully above everything else. Sweep them again. So we took out one squadron. Let's put in another fresh squadron here. B-38. Here's... Make sure we divide. Let them rest. We have another... Here's a P-38 squadron. Complete. These, really, against Nates, they're totally outclassed. The enemy. I'm keeping them as big groups, hopefully that it will, rather than going in as 8, 9, and 8s and whatnot, so it, you know, I'm hoping that there will be less chance of it dispersing or scattering. We're still, look at that, stack level way the hell over. But, well, do the best we can with what we got now. We could send the P-38 Foxes in after them as well. Okay, so we got the fighters up. Recon-wise, we will switch up. Yeah, we got some fatigue. Look at these guys. We flew all of them. So this squadron, rebuild. Holy cow, are we short pilots? Damn it. Did he manage to kill some pilots? Well, you guys are doing the grunt work, so you get the best pilots we have. Let's rest them. We'll split up the other three. Now, the five alphas, they have shorter range. Let's make sure we go in at 20,000. Replacements on. Divide. We're still going to conduct reconnaissance on Hiroshima. They still have ships here. Let's hit them again. The other recon, we're going to go over Tsushima. I don't know if recon makes a difference for Fukuoka. I was going to bomb Fukuoka, but there's ships here. I just like hitting. I just want to try for those big ships over in Hiroshima. So I'm not going to fly the last mission over Fukuoka. I don't think detection level plays a major role for fighter sweeps. I could be wrong. If someone thinks I'm in error, please let me know. But I don't think fighter sweeps are affected by detection level, because it has nothing to do with the ground. But I fully admit I could be wrong. Okay, these guys didn't fly at all. They got some experience. Hello? But they didn't fly. So I think I'm going to order them. We'll go port attack instead. There's a transport and a mine control ship here. If we won't attack maybe the detection level is too low. See, it's only 5-6. It could be too low. So let's try to kill the ships, and then if the detection level goes up, maybe we can kill the ground units. Okay, Joe? All right, 17 Echoes, you guys. Oh, crap. This is where we die. Let's get a bomber pilot in here. Yeah, we got, look at that, all 60s and 50s, we've got nobody in the way of bomber pilots. And I'm using good bomber pilots. Oops, what happened? Okay, we got 16. Oh, he's going to take 3 days to get over here. So we have really crap for... for pilots. Okay, we're going to rest these guys. See, I overstacked the number of aircraft and spares. That way, when we come back and they reduce it back down to 14, back to 4, that's fine. Looks like we're only able to fly 48 per day. So I've got to choose the next group of 48 to go. For simplicity, you know, here is 1, 2, 3. We could go with these four group of liberators. Let's see, are they in the same... Oh, yeah, even better. They're all from the same bomber command. That'll make it nice. Four from the 7th bomber command. Unfortunately, we can't filter according to bomber command. I wish I could just say, oh, yes, filter according to bomber command, and then we could just send all four. But nope. We have to manually click the hell out of... Yeah, I know. Sorry. Pain in the ass. Click. So maybe this is a trick to getting units to actually fly, smaller units, so that they can actually get off. Hopefully this will be one raid rather than spread out over 3 or 4, but we don't know. And here's another grouping of 4. See, we can send the B-41 Deltas. Next group of... Oh, there's 5 here. 4 or 5 bomb groups here. Next turn. Land-wise, we have more base forces arriving. Okay, we'll drop them in, get their construction started. We've got more construction battalion. Who else? Oops. We have another Bengal construction battalion arriving. Construction-wise, we are at 81%. We're going to make that jump within a turn or two. Great. We can use another 50 aircraft here. Still struggling to get supplies, but at least on Fusan, we've reached the 20,000 level, and that helps with getting replacements. Here's another frontier base force. Okay. Get building. Okay, Joe. No, nothing is... Slowly, another 3% only. No further conquest in Manchuria so far. We're now moving down on Orshan, trying to punch out this last... Yeah, this one. Last base here. So we're marching across. At least the last base to be taken was Heiho. And we're moving in the garrison right now. Getting on the rail. Getting it up here. Hoping it'll be around. At least the last bases to be taken, Orshan, Mishan, Gotao, and Fuchin, are not going to require garrisons. That's nice. Oh, one thing to note for Nud Kang, this is the garrison that's setting up for Heiho. I was originally going to just send it all the way to Heiho on rail, but it seems as though if I select Heiho by rail, it goes to the southwest. So it looks like it's going to try to make this rail run up here and then over. Now, what I'm concerned is, this unit has assault value. And I think that the rail usually travels 5 hexes per turn. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put it right on top of Hai Lun. Which makes it, if I have to go through here and risk triggering or auto flipping, auto capturing Hai Lun, well, it's not worth the candle. So what I'm going to do is, if I've got to go through, hopefully if I can run through here before it has a chance to check and flip, from here to here is about 5 hexes. So I'm going to run it down, from Hei, instead of going directly to Hei Ho, I'll run to Sichar, then up to Hei Ho, and then from here all the way up to Hei Ho, as long as it takes. That's what I'm hoping for. I would hate to lose my training base because of an error, but this unit stopped on the railway beside Hai Lun. We continue to push our reinforcements up. It looks like everyone managed to get back on the rail, on the railway. Okay, outside of Saigon, these guys are heading for Saigon. Fine, let's order them down to Cam Ranh if possible. At Cam Ranh, we want to make sure they're heading to the same place. So just in case, we'll set all to march for Hanoi, in case. At Saigon, we're using the Indian Corps here. I'm going to keep it back for a little while longer. This is my accelerator, my slingshot unit, for those who cannot use the rail. These guys are heading for Cam Ranh. I think I'm going to see. Please don't go to the back roads. Let's go to Hanoi. Right, southeast. That's good. Oh, these guys are somehow the Aussies always do things their way, don't they? Their own way. Okay, so they can't. You know, how long will that take to get to Cam Ranh? Probably faster, longer to go back than around. Oh well, 6 of 1 have to, just let them go. Just let them go. Another unit has, headquarters, X-Force has arrived at Mumian. Look at them, look at all that. They were 50% disabled when they started moving, and they still are. Oh well, get them into the movement mode. Heading for Bangkok, no rush. It's been quiet over here, not many air attacks, I don't think, so. Aircraft wise, we haven't been losing pilots, which is good, but we also don't get training when that happens. Okay, we have lots of spare, so let's just jam it up. If the AI taketh away from us, the AI taketh away. We're still bombing on Langkawi. Slowly, slowly. Alorastar, I think Alorastar was attacked. Yeah, look at all these aircraft damaged. Can't tell if any of them need a pilot, though. I think they're okay. Hell of a way to run a war, right? I can't tell which ones are loaded up with pilots. In the harbor, S-38 will upgrade a lot. S-40 has just come out, so we'll form some patrol. I don't know what's a good name for this passage that we're going to patrol. The AI's got minesweepers and something moving out here. Maybe I gotta go down to Batavia. Okay, let's patrol a little bit further. Right on the doorstep of Batavia. I don't want to enter the harbor. Probably mines, and it's shallower water. I think it might be more risky. It's all shallow water, so it's bad enough. I don't know if it's more risky going into a base hex too. I just don't know. We'll leave our dive bombers and Mitchells harassing the enemy. This Mitchell, geez, we only have 2. Let's make sure we have some spares up here. There's the enemy destroyer PT escorts. They're still active. Yeah, they're hunting us, and we're hunting them. Rangoon's quiet. Nobody's coming in because none of the ships have any supplies on the damn thing. Still fighting for supplies to get out of here with whatever we can load. We got 6,300. That's just nothing. That's just not enough. I think that the number of bombers can't fly. The bombers can't fly, or else they're restricted with the supplies in red. I'm not sure if the bombers are flying at all with the supply in brown or what the warning level. When I don't even have twice as many as requested, twice as many. Holy cow, we need 17,000. You need twice as many as requested for the bombers to fly. I think if you don't have enough, the bombers fly with their limited or extended range bomb loads. I'm not even sure if they'll fly at all at 6,300. Oh well. Nothing I can do about it. The railways either work or they don't. You have no control over them. Ceylon, the transport took a little while longer to unload. Unfortunately, that means these guys are just going to sit out here waiting for them. That's life. No rush. Troop transport coming in. Escorts coming out to meet them. Convoy inbound. No enemy activity. So it's just convoys in and out. Minor thing to note, I'm taking the short range ones are going back to Abadan to grab more fuel, mostly fuel. The long range ones I'm going to retask. We're heading off to Cape Town. Just waste of these great big ships. Might as well make them oceanic vessels. Bombay, we took one of those, the Peshawar Brigade. Remember that? That was the component part, I believe, from Rawalpindi. I brought them over since we can't upgrade with them or can't get them off the continent, or probably not. I brought it over to free up the 11th Indian. The 11th Indian is now going to the front. We'll send it down to Imphal. It's going to continue to take reinforcements. Yeah, look, we're 120 squads short. Can you believe that? But we better make sure we turn off the upgrade first while we travel. No reinforcements, South Africa. Submarine check. No additional submarines damaged. Check for endurance. Snapper. Oh, green thing harder. These guys are too. Yep. They're back. Oh, they're already heading back. I'm happy. Don't need to intervene. Torpedo check. That was easy. No submarine attacks that turn. Quiet on Timor. We haven't had a raid. When's the last time we had a raid here? Anyone remember? 2, 3, almost a month more? So I'm not going to. The Kitty Hawks have upgraded to level 3s. I'm not going to send them back up to Darwin. I probably should have just kept them as Kitty Hawk 1s and burned them up, but hey, oh well. Or leave them as, or put them as Spitfires. That's fine. I'm going to leave them here and train as escorts, yeah. So we'll just gain experience here. If I need them, I'll send them back out, just because it's more difficult to supply Darwin than it is to supply Townsville. I may actually pull back some of the other fighters too. We just don't need them out there. We're just burning supplies in a remote area as opposed to a built up area in the south. You know, these guys are at fatigue 11. Yeah, that doesn't sound like a bad idea. Maybe I'll just, later on, I'll replace them with 2 Kitty Hawk squadrons, and I'll pull back the Lightnings. Yeah, that's what I'll do. Let's rest, everybody. We were worried about the high altitude ones, but no, I think we can get away with that. The Kitty Hawks, the Warhawks will also rest. Sweep, recover, and then I'll pull them back to the south. For that reason, I'm going to send the two Aussie squadrons out here. Strap on the tanks. Transfer Darwin. Or did we crash one already? Oh, for the love of God. Are you kidding me? Yep. 15. Oh, man. You... Aussie driver. So the two Kitty Hawk squadrons, I hope, should be enough to deter an enemy attack. The minesweepers continued to duel with the enemy submarines. We got a couple of hits last... I think we got a couple of hits last time. Or maybe it was the turn before. My mistake. The replenishment convoy has returned. We replenished from port. Disband for repairs. Oh, it looks like the... Where is that? Rigel! No. Where's the damaged... Ah, the Medusa is in port. Pierside. Wow. We can't even repair it at shipyard. That's not good. That's not good at all. So it does seem pretty moot. I don't have a choice. I did not think it was this serious, this bad. If we take the Jackson out of shipyard, let's see. If we did it, and put Medusa in. No, the shipyard just is unable to fix this damn thing. Holy crap. Okay. Yeah, it will not fix. Okay, let's put it back under readiness and prepare it for departure. No choice. Sydney or bust. The other little ones we will repair. Yeah, these are just the little eight transports that took a little flooding on their run out to Guadalcanal. The sub chasers that are upgrading. Okay, for the next, that's going to be one. How far is Sydney? 9 days. We might have to drop in a Newcastle. Okay, so we were traveling 3 hexes per day, 3 days in submarine infested waters. Ooh. Interesting times ahead. New Zealand. I think our boat has arrived. Yes, our transport has arrived. Let's form transport. Do not steal fuel. Do not unload. Let's try to... It was end detachment, right? Uh-oh. Says we... I wish we could know, huh? 95%. Freaking idiots! This is nonsense. Okay, 95% isn't good enough. You're taking... It's half-assed. Let's see this one. Well, this one says it'll go. This one has a little bit of assault value too. 9 assault value, so... You're it, baby. Okay. Incompetent ass. Right, we'll sail off for Suva. As soon as we load. Ah, I have a brainstorm here. Okay. We're going to switch this around. Adjust. Loading, not loading, loading stopped. Reallocate. Accept. Okay, we're not going to load anything. We wasted up a few operational points, and then we're not, and that's okay. What we're going to do is we're going to load the end detachment. Why? Because it's got assault value. Assault value means troops. We're going to take the 95% that we can. Okay, we'll take it. Accept and go. Now, watch. Rather than jerking around and trying to pick up the last 5% or a few squads on there, what I'll probably do is, here's end detachment. We've already loaded, let's say, a couple of one squad onto the ship. Notice this, we can still disband the rest. So if there's going to be a bunch of support squads that can't make it onto the boat, I'm just going to disband it, and then we'll add them on when we get to the location, rather than jerking around sending another boat to filling up a big boat with 10 or 20 squads, not even 10 or 20 squads. I'll just disband it, put them into the pool, and then pick them up as have them re-added to the unit at the end. All it does is take an expenditure of supplies if the squads are available. I think that's the way I'll do it. Hope everyone understood what the hell I just said there. No activity in Suva, just transports moving around. Chicot has arrived. Balboa. Simple. Just send them all the way to Guam. Do not grab their fuel though, but go ahead and unload. Pearl Harbor. More ships still returning. Tangier for upgrade. The two repair vessels also upgrade. Nothing else has repaired. Nowhere. Nothing going out. The transports have come in, unloaded, and got the hell out already. Great. Now we gotta turn on their refueling. Another transport group. Wow. Stealthy. In, bam, and gone before we even knew it. No reinforcements on the West Coast, but these engineering aviation battalions are ready now. I think we're going to take the small one. What's the small one? The 1881st. Okay. We have one. Oops. Where is it? One transport, Benjamin Holt, Liberty class. I don't know how if it'll be big enough, but let's try. This is a smaller one, right? If we take the bigger one, it'll say, yeah, 99%. No, not big enough. Let's take the smaller one. Okay. Accept. Off to Guam. No other ships are available. I think I might have solved part of the problem of where to get the buttons. When the headquarters unit, this is the command headquarters, when we return to West Coast, the West Coast command over to San Francisco, we often get a nice helpful button to bring them here now. So maybe that does help. I'll try to leave it here. It doesn't really matter where the West Coast headquarters is. It doesn't do anything other than be a headquarters. We're up another 200,000 in supply, so okay, we're bringing something on here. Maybe by the time the ships are ready in a week or so, we'll have some supplies to move. On Vancouver, we have transports returning. Let's disband. I think these are, they're all going to be repaired before we can send them back out on the supply run. Here's a transport heading out. Oh! Where are we heading? Guam, I guess. Yeah. See how they're partially loaded? And we'll waste another turn finishing them off. We'll finish them this turn, and out they go. I'm going to take the tanker. Let's take the tanker. It's too slow. So what I'll do is I'm going to use it. I'll do a specific run for Pearl Harbor and return. At Guam, we've lost the enemy submarine. Maybe he's gone back for repairs. Crud. Okay, the transport that just unloaded the convoy, we're grabbing them and repairing them, or trying to repair as best we can out here. Got another 100,000, 150,000 worth of fuel. So that's, 200,000 total here? Over 200,000? That's going to put us over a million easily. We just don't. We can't use it anymore. Just can't use it. That'll take us a year to burn up. Anyway, we've got our, here's our AOs. Make sure the AOs are always loaded as best we can. And we'll try to pump out all the slightly damaged transports. at Hahajima, the tenders are all, look at that, all almost empty. When the tenders are done, the battleships are done. There's no way we can load up otherwise as quickly. So the tenders, we just to give an amount, an idea, the whole tender force here, the ammunition ships, had about 100,000 worth of supplies on them. 100,000 plus what we sucked out of the base when we dropped it on the base. It's simply incredible. Okay, the function of the base is to load the tenders. Fine, load the tenders. We've reformed the two battleship groups. We're going to rest the Tennessee and Maryland. The other ones are going off to wreak havoc. Where is this one? Chichijima. We've got about six battleships heading out both directions. Here comes the replenishment group. I don't think they're going to get in here in time before the battleships run out. We have one. We have today's bombardment, maybe one more before these guys can arrive. The enemy, with his Betty bombers, did make an attack on us, and we put up over 100 fighters. Even with six, it just every time all he needs is to get one through, put another torpedo into one of my battleships. Those are my nightmares. Wow. Not much you can do about it. A couple of transport groups, E-boat, transport, nothing to worry. Submarine attack. Oh, it's a loaded transport. Good to see. A personnel transport. Three torpedo hits. She's a goner. Good hunting. Air attack. Hahajima. Betty's at night. Nothing. Hiroshima bombed by night. The liberators. Oh, great. We hit the tanker again and the repair vessel. Oh, sorry. The aviation seaplane tender. Bombed again. Nothing worthwhile. We're just gonna... No hits. Well, two bomb hits of any significance. Iwo Jima bombed again. Bombarded again. Great. Still killing something, but too slowly. Chichijima bombarded. We do get some more casualties. Keep them wearing them down. K-11 fires four torpedoes at an E-boat, Suta. Miss. And then gets hit in return. Well, that's what happens when you miss. Pompon evades near Kochi. Palau fires two torpedoes at a destroyer. Evades. Duds. Attack on the Chinese corps at Fuchao. That hasn't happened in a long time. Looks like the fighters over at Amoy were unable to intercept. Well, we'll see if it continues. And steps need to be taken. One support squad disabled. We need over near Singapore. B-25 Mitchell has hit the... we hit this before. Well, supposedly hit it before. Maybe it's another false report. Air attack Fuchao. No interceptors. I guess the coverage from Amoy isn't sufficient. An air attack Hahajima. Whoa! How the... He brought zeros this range? Oh my goodness! Good for him. Or is... unless, of course, there's a carrier around here. No. Two Wildcats destroyed. And the Bettys... Five Bettys as well. Air attack, Hahajima. Another Betty shot down. Air attack, Alor Star. 80 fighters up. You only get two, and we lose a Warhawk. Kota Baru under attack. Two enemy planes shot down. Bombing practice, Majuro. Bombing practice, Akyab. Bombing practice, I guess, Langkawi. Just note, when we were bombing at Akyab, at least there, that means there are supplies reaching Chittagong for the planes to use. So, not a total loss. Ventura's miss. Ventura's... Ah! Two support squads destroyed. I think this is probably just a base force unit over there. So, we're starting to wipe them out. More bombing practice, Akyab. Bombing practice, Nakhon Ratchasima. Air raid to rain as we're on the train traveling past. Man, the AI's ability to, it's like picking off a bullet with a bullet. One squad disabled. Pompano, oh no! It caught by a anti-submarine group, hit 16 times, forced to the surface, and destroyed. Bastard! That's sub number... I think we had 18, that's sub number 19 to die in this war.